Hey everyone, so today I wanted to make a video on how to add captions to a video using a free online tool called Amara. And so this would typically be used when you have like a video and the author has not written official captions for it. And so all you have is like YouTube's auto caption, and we all know how useful those are. So let me go ahead and tell you how to do this. So first, what you want to do is click on the URL of the video you want to for which you want to create captions. So in my case, I'm on a Mac, so I hit Control or Command C to copy, and then, if you're on Windows, you'd hit Control C. So now I go to amara.org, and here, because I'm logged in, it has my username, but if you're not logged in, it'll just probably have like create new user. So you have to create a new user and then verify your email address and all that. But since I'm already logged in, I'm just gonna go ahead and hit subtitle video. So in this field, I'm going to Command V or Control V paste the video. And so I click begin, and then it creates a page for it. And so what I'm going to do is over here on under Contribute, click Add a New Language. So the video is in English, and then we're subtitling into English, or I guess captioning, but whatever. So continue. And this is the caption writing page. So immediately you notice up here on the left, there are a series of like hotkey commands. So the first of which is tab. So like if I'm just typing captions here on a regular keyboard, if I hit tab, what it does is it starts and stops the video. So tab,
Hey everybody. So I want to talk to you.
and then tab again to stop it, right? The next one is skip back. So like if you press the shift on the left side plus tab, it skips the video backward like a couple seconds. So let me demonstrate. So
It's
back.
about loops. Talk to you about. So I want to talk. Hey everybody.
So see how I'm now all the way at the beginning of the video. So the next one is shift plus enter. This inserts a line break within the same caption box. So see how this is highlighted right now? Each caption appears in its own box in this like creating tool. So like you can't just keep typing out the captions and have it won't like automatically divide them up into like the chunks that you see on the screen. So like when you press what it's saying is like if you press shift enter, it adds a new line on the second one. But I typically like to keep my captions one line only, so I don't ever use that. So I just use regular enter, which creates a new caption box. And so every successive enter is a new caption. So like you have to actually like keep track of how long each caption is. And I think this has like a character limit where it starts getting angry. Yeah. Line length shouldn't exceed 42 characters, whatever. It'll still let you proceed, so it doesn't really matter, but whatever. Anyway, so I'm just going to delete these again. So you just hit this wrench and then the little X to delete it, whatever. Okay, so I'm going to be doing this with Plover. If you're on Eclipse or on Case Catalyst, it's going to be slightly different. On Eclipse, I know because I use Eclipse, you just need to go into user settings and then create basically, keyboard macros that you can execute from your steno keyboard, which is an entirely separate video. I'll probably do that later. But I'm going to do it with Plover. So these instructions are for how to do it with Plover. So first, before you do this, you're going to want to enter a series of dictionary entries. And these are the entries that you would use in Plover. So to go back, so skip back is shift and tab, right? So I actually made my back command bake with the star key. And then if you put this entry into your Plover dictionary, it will simultaneously hit the left shift and then pr press tab at the same time. So in essence, this hotkey command. And when I want to play or pause the video, I just push tab with the star key to make it just press tab on the keyboard. And then I use RRN or rern to make a new line, which divides the captions up. Like I said, you can't, it doesn't do it automatically. You have to remember to start new lines. And then in this case, the speaker is Matt Short. So I like In class, he goes by Shorty, so I'm just going to use Shorty as a speaker designation. Show is the steno stroke that I use. And it essentially just hits return, deletes a space, writes his name, colon, and then capitalizes the next word. Cool. So once you got those in your steno dictionary, I'm going to start Plover now. I have my steno machine hooked up. So I'm going to make sure this is way all the way at the beginning of the video, right? Okay. So, wait, I need this back on. Hold on. Sorry, my little speaker turned off. Okay, so I'm going to insert my cursor here, and then I'm going to hit show, right, to make the speaker designation. Oops, I don't know why I made two lines. And then I'll just hit tab on my steno machine, and then just start writing what he says. So let's do it.
Hey, everybody. So I want to talk to you about loops. So I want to talk to you about while loops. I want to talk to you about until loops, which are just like Ruby has if and unless. It also has while and until. And then I want to show you some alternate syntax. There's also loop do and some other things. So let's build some code. So let's start with setting a variable and say while, and we can put our test here. X is less than 10, puts X, and X plus equals 1. All right.
And then, so see how I fell.
This is the same as.
So see how I fell kind of behind. So now I'm just going to hit bake on my steno machine to make it go back. So hold on.
As a while loop in JavaScript, all right, plus equals 1, and X plus equals 1.
Wait, oops, all right. Sorry, hold on.
This one puts X.
But see how I'm doing this all from my steno machine, anyway.
And X plus equals 1, X, and we can put our test here. X is less than 10, puts X.
Then new line.
And X plus equals 1. All right, and so let's talk about this. This is the same as a while loop in JavaScript. We have a condition, right? This is our line with a condition. And if the condition is true, we go inside and we execute code, and then we can do whatever we want here. And so in this case, we're going to increment X by 1 each time. So we should put 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then when X becomes 10, after spinning out 9, the while loop should stop. And so we should get 5, 3, while loop should stop.
Whatever. Okay, that's good enough. What did he say? After becoming 10, whatever. Oops.
And so we should get 5 through 9, and the code should stop.
So whatever. Okay, that's done. Now, if you have any blank captions here, it's going to not let you go forward. Oh, wait. Oh, I guess it did. Huh, that's funny. But sometimes when you... Oh, it just got rid of it automatically because it was at the end. But normally, if you try to do that, it'll be grayed out like this, so you can't go forward. So in that case, it'll give you a link. It says captions cannot be blank, and it'll just, like, boom, like, find the spot where you were, where it was just, you know, like a... you know, like a blank caption like this. So it'll find that, and then you have to either like go here and delete it or like fill it with something. But anyway, it let us go through, so I have no clue what happened. Anyway, so now this is the second portion of the step. So after you've written all the captions, now you have to sync it to the audio. So what you do is you have the same command before, the tab, and then the shift tab, which skips back. But now you have down to start a subtitle, and then you have up to end a subtitle. So I think of it as like planting like a flag down, and then like, I don't know, pulling it up. I guess like my analogy is kind of breaking down. But anyway, so I hit tab.
So
oops. Oh shit.
Hey everybody.
So he says, "Hey everybody," right here. So put the caption down.
Buddy. So.
And that's where he starts saying so. So I end the first caption by pressing up. Then I press down to start the new caption.
I want to talk to you about loops.
So see, I'm always watching this line right here. So
I want
I'm waiting for the next line to start. So he stopped saying loops right here and then started saying, "So I want to talk to you."
I'll talk to you about while loops. I want to
And then so again, up to end caption, down to begin the new one.
talk to you about until loops, which
Up to end, down to start.
are just like Ruby has if and unless.
Up, down to start
It
the new
also
one.
has while and until. And then I'll
So after you get used to that, you can get really fast at it. So you can just let it play. So, watch.
Show you some
Oops, sorry.
I'll show you some alternate syntax. There's also loop do and some other things. So let's build some code. So let's start with setting a variable and say
So see how I'm stopping right when he starts the new dialogue or the next caption? I stop it with tab, I hit up to end the last caption, and then press down to start the new one. So keep going.
while. And we can put our test here. X is less than 10. What's X?
And this is kind of long for such a short caption, so I'm just gonna shorten it so it doesn't like stay on the screen. So
What's
see how
X?
it's the watch. See. Or I guess you can't really see, but whatever.
And X.
Then oh fuck. Sorry. So that's where he starts saying nx plus
And
one
X plus equals
or
1.
plus equals on
All
y.
right. And so let's talk about this. This is the same as a while loop in JavaScript. We have a condition, right? This is our line with a condition. And if the condition is true, we go.
So I accidentally started this too late, so I'm gonna shorten that and move this back up. Oh fuck.
We go inside and we execute code, and then we can do whatever we want here. And so in this case, we're going to.
And see, this was we're going to, not we want to, so we can actually do edits that way.
Increment x.
Oh shit. There you go.
By 1 each time. So we should put 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then when
Then when?
x becomes 10 after spitting out 9.
After spitting, whatever. Go back to my stunner machine, spitting out 9.
The while loop should stop.
Stop. Cool. That's all we have so far, right? So, now the next step is, so obviously I'm not going to do the whole thing, but you would have this all the way to the end. Hit start review, and then if you've been paying attention the whole time, it should be already all correct. So you just give it a
Hey
quick look
everybody.
through. You just give it a quick look through, sorry.
So I want to talk to you about loops. So I want to talk to you about while loops. I want to talk to you about until.
So it looks pretty good. So you hit publish. And then now this is the page you actually send to your consumer. So this you just, just to prove, if I open a new tab, paste that exact, this URL in, like it's the page. And so the consumer will watch the video in Amara's player right here.
Everybody.
And
So I want to
voila,
talk to you.
you have captions. Ta-da. So one little caveat or a couple caveats about this is this is not YouTube. This is like wrapped inside of Amara's little player. So you like can't full screen it, which is really annoying. So like if you have to see what's going on in the screen, I guess just hit like Command plus or Control plus to just make it bigger like that. Like it's kind of a hacky, like not really a fix, but I mean this functionality hasn't existed in Amara for like ever. And then the other thing is sometimes this caption like blocks off the controls, so you have to turn off the captions to like access this with access the progress bar, which is really annoying, but whatever. But yeah, that's it. That is how to caption videos that don't have captioning on YouTube, and I hope this was helpful. And if you have any questions or comments, let me know in the comment section. All right, bye.